Despite the daily tragedies dealt with by those in the lower classes during the Industrial Revolution of harsh working conditions and unforgiving labor, the working classes aided in the technological and medical advancement of Britain and the world. Therefore, the Industrial Revolution was a tragedy for some, but a triumph for all in the end. The Industrial Revolution lasted from the early 1700s to the late 1800s. It originated in Britain and later spread throughout the rest of the world. Some of the most influential people of this time include Queen Victoria, born in 1819 and died in 1901. The Victorian era was named after Queen Victoria due to her long and powerful rule. Charles Dickens was born in 1812 and was thought to be one of the greatest writers of his time. He wrote 15 novels. Some of his most popular include Oliver Twist, which tells the story of the daily life of an orphan during the Victorian era. This story was inspired by the large number of orphans that there were at the time. Another well-known book, A Christmas Carol, is a Christmas ghost story, inspired by the large number of people that made up the poor and lower classes. Charles Dickens died in 1870. Louis Pasteur developed a vaccine against rabies. James Watt invented the steam engine. Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone. And Charles Darwin introduced the theories of natural selection and evolution. The world itself was going through a great deal of evolution at the time. Before the Industrial Revolution, many people lived in small farming villages where they grew and raised their own food and produced their own goods. Even cloth was made in villages. This time period is known as the cottage industry. Merchants traveled from door to door selling raw wool. It was then further prepared on a spinning wheel. Merchants could get the cloth back and sell it for a higher price. The merchants made so much money off of textiles that they needed a faster way to produce them. Eventually, laws were passed that allowed wealthy landowners to fence off their land. This allowed them to make more money because they could farm larger amounts of land. These landowners started putting their money towards new industries, such as goods being produced in factories. However, this enclosure forced many small farmers off of their farms that they had worked on for years. They moved into the cities in hope of finding work. For the next 200 years, the Industrial Revolution would evolve along the political revolution in Europe and spread to many other parts of the world. There were many more good outcomes from the Industrial Revolution other than advanced technology and medicine. The standard of living for many people in the middle and upper classes was raised. Transportation and communication improved with inventions like the steam engine and the telephone, and textile industries were suddenly much more successful. City populations grew, which meant that there were more people available to work and that cities made more money. Before the Industrial Revolution, women were thought to simply be there to take care of the household and children. However, the Industrial Revolution offered working opportunities for women, and city life offered an education. A greater amount of people were being employed, and almost everyone was making money, so fewer people were homeless. Many people made more money working in factories than they did before on the farms. A large number of goods could be made in factories. This allowed the goods to be produced faster and with higher quality, which improved people's health. More goods were made available for more people, so fewer people were starving. Some workers, especially the children, were even provided with food during their shifts. An article from November 16, 1833, in the Penny Magazine states, "The industry of the young not only contributes to the increase of our national wealth, but also to their own advantage. In many factories, they are not only usefully employed, but at the same time are trained up in those habits of mortality and good feeling which are most likely to make them valuable members of society." Child workers of the Industrial Revolution were sculpted into fine young men and women through factory work.
The lower classes worked in factories for pay and food. This was mainly because they needed to provide for their families. They barely made enough money to stay alive. There were many orphans at the time as well. Society was divided into three classes. The upper class was made of rich factory owners and wealthy landowners. People in the middle class consisted of managers, lawyers, doctors, and engineers. The lower classes were the poor factory and mine workers. Nobody worked as a family, but in factories with strangers. Many people worked 6 days a week and up to 18 hours a day. Unskilled workers were often with little job security and were easily replaceable. For those that were provided with food at work, they arrived around 5 in the morning with empty stomachs. Breakfast wasn't provided for another 4 hours and often consisted of oat cakes and cans of boiled milk or water. They ate at their workstations and weren't given many breaks. Once a year, workers were provided with cheese and brown bread for a special dinner. Factory work was dangerous, and there were very little safety measures. Many workers were injured, such as the popular loss of fingers or limbs. Death was common. Industrialization also meant that some people were released from their jobs and replaced by machines. Sickness and disease spread easily in the populated cities, and pollution from the factories dirtied the air and rivers, causing havoc on the environment.
Child labor was a big problem. Many children needed to help provide for their families, and many orphans were available to work in the factories. Children could fit into small spaces in the machinery or mines that adults couldn't, they demanded less money, and they were easy to manipulate. According to History.com, children had been servants and apprentices throughout most of human history. However, child labor reached new extremes during the Industrial Revolution. Many children developed breathing problems and became sick with an illness called mill fever. This was caused by the dust, gas, grease, and oil that filled the surrounding air. The main jobs for children were breaker boys, which worked in the mines, and match girls, who made matches. If a child worked neither of these jobs, they were stuck cleaning and operating the machines. Breaker boys were usually between the ages of 8 and 12. Their main job was to separate coal by hand. The coal often cut up their fingers, and their working environments were filled with coal dust. Many developed asthma or lung cancer. Their shifts were normally 10 hours. As for the match girls, they were typically ages 4 to 16. They dipped the ends of matchsticks into a toxic chemical called phosphorus. This poisonous chemical often resulted in many girls developing fossy jaw, a bone cancer that disintegrates part of the jaw. Eventually, the cancer could kill the girls. They generally worked 12-hour shifts in the factories and were often fined or fired for simply talking to one another, sitting down, or dropping a match. Misbehavior could also lead to beatings. A written account from a 6-year-old boy who worked in a textile factory describes, "I have frequently worked at the frame till I could scarcely get home, and in this state have been stopped by people in the streets who noticed me shuffling along and advised me to work no more in the factories, but I was not my own master. During the day, I frequently counted the clock and calculated how many hours I still had to remain at work. My evenings were spent in preparing for the following day, in rubbing my knees, ankles, elbows, and wrists with oil. I went to bed to cry myself to sleep and pray that the Lord would take me to Himself before morning." Eventually, the government started to raise awareness for the workers in the early 1900s. The Factory Acts didn't allow anyone under the age of 9 to work. Those between the ages of 9 and 16 couldn't work more than 16 hours a day, which was a triumph for many young workers. Steps were taken to improve working environments, such as increases in sanitation and safety measures becoming more strict. Food and water for the lower classes was made more available and with higher quality. Pollution was reduced, which helped to get the environment back on its feet. Many workers went through unspeakable tragedy. Some sacrificed their health and even their lives so that our world could advance in technology and medicine, therefore taking a triumphant and tremendous leap into the future. Those babies all went on the job the same as you and mine. I know you're glad that things have changed, for we have lots of fun as we go in and do the jobs that babies used to run. Come out of bed, little sleepy head, and get your bite to eat. The factory whistle's calling you, there's no more time to sleep.